adding and subtracting scientific notation. Now, here I'm going to go over the following four questions and examples and a process that you can solve these questions without using a calculator. But I will try to show both. First example, which is this one right here. It's the easiest one, but it will underline what is needed to know this process of adding and subtracting. I have two numbers that are in scientific notation, and I am trying to add them. In addition or in subtraction, the key item is that you want to have the exponent of your base 10 to be identical. This is not always the case. In fact, maybe most of the time it will not be the case. As you can see, the other three examples, they do not have the same exponents. Now, if the exponent is the same, then the question boils down to simply adding or subtracting your leading two numbers. And if I add these two numbers, I'll do it here, okay, on the right hand side. Then I am done. Nothing happens to the base 10 or the exponent. All I have to worry about, in this case, is the mantissa, or the leading two numbers. I am finished for this example. The reason why I bring this example is because I want you to really focus in that you will need to make the exponents always be the same. Let's try the second example, which is a touch different. So my second example uses the same two leading numbers. However, now my problem is that my exponent is not the same. So I can't just add them as I please. I will have to make the exponents the same. Now, in order to make this work, I have to make these two guys the same. What I like to always pick is I choose the largest exponent. In this case, it's the 58. And the largest exponent, that number will stay the same. So notice it's identical. However, the one with the different exponent, I will have to change. Now, what has happened here? If I changed from 57 to 58, well, I made it bigger by one. And here, the concept of bigger, smaller, in one of the other videos I made, you can look over. If this gets bigger, that means my decimal is going to have to make that number smaller, which means I'm going to have to shift it to make it smaller in magnitude by one. So it shifted from here. So that got smaller. Okay, by one. Now I do have the same exponents, which is what I wanted, and it's exactly the same question as before, meaning I can just simply now take my two leading numbers and add them up. So nothing to add here, 3. So my answer overall is that. So remember that you have to make the exponents the same, and you can use this bigger, smaller. If you've forgotten that, you can watch the video, and I will link it in the show notes if you hit show notes for this. So that's second example. And I do want to show you that you can do this on a calculator if you were allowed. So for instance, okay, if I have a calculator here, I'll put the numbers in brackets here. So it was 3.1 times 10 to the exponent, and it was 58, okay, plus it was, let me just double check, 2.2 times 10 to the 57, 2.2 times 10 to the 57. And if I hit equals, notice that's exactly what it is. For those who have an exponent button for powers of 10 on this calculator that you're seeing on the screen, it is that capital E on the top left-hand corner. Some calculators have it as a double E, so double capital E. That's something that you would have to check on your calculator. But if you have that one, you can, instead of pressing times 10 to the power of, you can just say E, and it was to the power of 58. And that's exactly the same thing. Okay? So plus, and then it was 2.2 times 10 to the power of 57. And notice it gives you the same thing. That's for those who have a calculator that has a capital E, or sometimes double capital E. And you can ask your teachers for that. Coming back to our questions, let me now take a look what happens here. And now I have negative 5 exponents, and I'll show you that it's no different. My exponents are different. And maybe for this one, what we'll do is, so we're still adding. Again, I have to pick the largest exponent. Be careful. In this case, negative 100 is larger than negative 102. So this will stay the same as it is, plus. And this, I will have to change. Now, that means I had to make it bigger by 2. And therefore, this will get smaller by 2. I'm going to have to shift the decimal over 2 places to make it smaller. Now the exponents are the same. And I can go ahead and work with the leading numbers, which means I have the following to do. And this is why knowing how to add and subtract decimals is useful. So I know that my answer will be negative because this is bigger than that. However, if you don't have a calculator, you're gonna have to know that you will be subtracting these. I'm gonna subtract. Okay, so I'm gonna borrow away. So I can't borrow from the 0, so I'll borrow from this. So this will turn into 80 9. This will be 10. So again, I borrowed 1 from this 90 here because I couldn't borrow it from the 0. Now 10 minus 5, so that's 5. 9 minus 3, which is 6. 8 minus 0, which is 8. The decimal stays the same. And then I have 1. So we said that the answer is negative. The exponent stays the same. And you're done that question. So you can review this to see how to do something like that. Let's take a look at the last example, which is a little torturous because it has 3 instead of 2 scientific notation numbers. I'm going to again look at the exponents. Actually, in this case, they're all different. I will pick the largest one. In this case, they're positive. So I will take the biggest one from here. And change all the other ones to be identical to it. So I have to change all of them to 321. So first, 319, I've got bigger by 2. And 320 got bigger by 1, which means I'm going to rewrite this. So if this got bigger by 2, this will get smaller by 2, meaning I'm going to get that. Notice it got smaller in magnitude. And here it will get smaller by 1. And notice that. And now my exponent is the same. So I have the same exponent. And I will have to work in adding and subtracting these. So start from the left and then just go one by one. So for instance, I can do this first, 4.8. minus 0.011. Again, there's zeros here. So let me subtract. Like in the previous case, I can't borrow from the 0, so I'll borrow from the 80. That's going to be 79. 10 minus 1 is 9. 9 minus 1 is 8. 7 minus 0, that's 7. Decimal stays the same. And now the answer is positive because 4.8 is much bigger than that. So I have 4.789. Now I'm going to have to add it to 0.91. So let's do that. Obviously, adding two positive numbers would be positive. 9, 9, 16, carry my 1. And there you have it. Okay, so your final answer, exponent will not change. I hope that you found these examples useful. They're painful, very painful, and it's extremely rare that you would have to do this in real life. You most likely would use a calculator, but if it so happens you can't use one, this is a great process of knowing how to do these questions. Thank you for watching.